What is it you love about voicing Finn? What is it?
Well, I get to say a lot of very fun catchphrases and also very weird things that are sometimes uncomfortable, but awesome. And I get to work with, you know, some of the most hilarious, awesome voice actors that have ever lived. I mean, just the best of the best on a weekly basis, which is just such a joy. And I get to scream a lot. And I get paid to scream a lot, so that's really cool.
So if you had a particularly bad day, you just scream it all away.
Exactly. Just angrily scream as I'm punching some demon in the face or something. It's awesome. Sometimes it's nice to be incognito. I feel like if I was at a store and I was ordering food or something and there was like, oh, this is on sale, and I was like, Schmelzow! It might give me away just a little bit. So I try not to. I actually enjoy seeing people that have like Adventure Time shirts on or something to love the show, and I'll be like, oh, that's a really cool show. And they're like, oh yeah, I love that show. And it's fun when you're talking to someone who's a fan of yours and they don't even know that you're the person they're a fan of. And you can kind of mess them sometimes too. I like doing that.
Have you ever done it to like mess people up at a drive-thru, just do it in the voice of Finn and just see if they've actually
I've done stuff like that. Yeah, I've done like prank calls and stuff to people. Like friends are like, oh, my friend is a big fan, can you like prank call them as Finn? And I'll do that, and half the time they're like, that's a crappy Finn impression. Throughout the whole first season, I went through something called puberty, and voice change, man, it's very fun stuff. So throughout the whole first season, all the screams and all the voice cracks and stuff were definitely not intentional. That's just the fact that I was going through voice change. And it sounded great for the character and they loved it. And post that, you know, it's obviously not my normal voice anymore. It's much higher pitched. But honestly, at the beginning, it was kind of just a very animated, energetic version of myself. And I think that's also why Finn has more of a, obviously like a natural tone to him. He doesn't, there's some characters that are awesome and sound more like specific characters. There's some characters that have more of a natural voice, and Finn is definitely more in the natural voice category.
What's it like being here in front of all these people and walking out like that to a screaming ovation?
It's awesome. It's super cool. I always appreciate when people are just excited. It's just fun to be in a room that's excited and filled with awesome, fun fans. And it's just, I don't know, it's a lot of fun. It's also very blinding because there's lots of light in my face and I can't really see any of you, to be completely honest. But yeah.
Yeah, I know the feeling. I'm just looking out thinking, how can anyone see you? But for you, you spend a lot of time for Adventure Time. You're recording in a booth. It's kind of very insular feeling as well. I mean, Adventure Time is slightly different, though. You sometimes have cast recordings, don't you?
Yeah. We usually, it depends, it differs from different animated shows, but for Adventure Time, usually, for the most part, we have ensemble records, so most of the cast is there recording together in the episode, which is a lot of fun, because in the booth, you get to kind of play off each other, you really get to know your castmates, and you build up that kind of chemistry and camaraderie, and I think it also just lends itself to having better episodes, and I think the reactions from each actor just sounds better when you're actually in the room together, because it has a more natural feel because you're actually there recording together. It's also nice because when you do it that way a lot, you get used to it, and you also really, really know how the other, specifically the other voice actors on Adventure Time, how they kind of approach doing lines and stuff. So then in the cases where you do have to be alone, like if you do have to, if you miss a record because I'm traveling or something and I have to come back and make up an episode, I know them so well that you can kind of hear and you kind of know in your head how they're going to approach a line and how they're going to say a line. And it makes it a lot easier when you have to do solo records as well.
What's your favorite catchphrase on the whole show?
Gosh, it's so hard. There's so many. I mean, I think the good go-tos, I love mathematical. I love schmauzow. Slam a cow's good. I like, there's one that's like kind of a sung thing. He's talking to, I think it's an Abracadaniel episode, and he goes, wands are for wimps. I don't know. I like that. Just wands are for wimps. It's awesome.
Now, has there ever been a phrase that you've kind of read and thought, how am I going to say that?
Yeah, I think that's most the scripts just overall. You're like, I mean, half the time I read stuff and I'm like, am I supposed to read this as it is, or is this just a typo? I really don't know. And then like, no, it's good. Just read it like that. And you're like, okay, sounds good. I mean, half of them are made up words, but when you're listening back to the show and you're watching it back, it totally makes sense. And it's just like, it's perfect for the show. That's one of the most endearing parts of it. That's one of the reasons why it's so awesome, is because you have these extremely bizarre phrases and words, and even sometimes when you're saying normal things, the way they'll have us say them can be very, very weird. I don't know what episode it's from, but one of my favorite lines, and I say this to Jake in an episode, I can't remember, I gotta find it, but he just says this to Jake like this. He just goes, "I want you." I don't know. I don't remember what the context was. I just remember they're like, "We want you to say it like that." I was like, "Okay," and I did it. I was like, "That's the creepiest, weirdest." It's just fun.
Good morning.
Hello.
Now, in occasional episodes in Adventure Time, Finn has a very characteristic high-pitched shriek.
Yeah.
Can you still make that shriek? And how much do you dread it if
no.
it comes up?
No. No, I'm kidding. I'm trying to think. Oh, let me see if I can do it, Frick. I know exactly what you're talking about. It sounds almost like a fire alarm type shriek.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can actually hit that note anymore.
Crap.
It's so high-pitched.
You can take your time. It's okay.
He's directing you now.
I know. It's okay. Take your time. You can get it. We'll do one take. I think that's about as high as I can get it at this point. And for those of you wondering, no, they didn't edit that shriek at all. It's just, I don't even know how the heck I hit it on the day that I did that thing. It was like a fluke thing. And it was like one take. And they're like, "That's perfect. Awesome. We'll put that in there."
You do a great job. Thank you.
Thank you very much.